This week I was a bit startled when I saw a new comment all in capital letters. I had said that heat doesn't go upwards by itself. The comment writer was right, and I was right, at least in the actual context. Hot air and heat pumps, they are very different indeed. Let's see how, and also how we can use it to save money in the coming winter. Hi, Norbert here. I'm an energy engineer. In video number 80, I explain how to save energy and increase comfort with a very low additional consumption of about 30 watts. What is the problem? Have you ever felt cold at your feet, even when your heating was running full power? Well, that's because warm air rises while you are in the cold zone on the floor. Today we'll talk about fixing this problem with a simple and affordable solution without living on the ceiling.
Warm air naturally rises, and that's great for balloons, but terrible for heating your home. This process, called stratification, means that warm air collects near the ceiling, often leaving a 1 degree Celsius temperature difference between your head and feet, if you are sitting at least, indeed for every meter of height difference. In my first home in Italy, with a ceiling more than 3 meters high, I noticed an 8 degree Celsius difference between the floor and the ceiling. It was uncomfortable and inefficient until I installed a vertical fan. Problem solved.
This week I found this comment warning me for saying in the last video that heat doesn't go upwards by itself. He thought that I meant hot air, and that indeed rises. But I was actually talking about heat pumps. Sorry for not being more explicit. The fact is that heat really doesn't go upwards on the temperature scale. It goes always from hot to cold by itself. But heat pumps can push heat from cold to hot, making them seem magical. This comment remembered me an experiment 30 years ago with a ceiling fan. So I thought you might be interested if I give examples how you can benefit from these two technologies, so the heat pumps and the ceiling fans. And by the way, my micro CHP project makes progress, but I have not enough to show this week. So today we fix on fixing this problem of stratification, recovering that precious warm air at the ceiling and getting it back where it belongs, near you. Before we go on, a few words to invite you to the community of energy home do-it-yourself. The recent quick growth of the electrical demand, problems of the grid to follow this demand, and the climate change underscore the pressing need of community-driven energy solutions. In other words, let households be the cornerstone in the energy transition that's going far too slow now. With climate actions, the coming 15 years will be decisive between global disorder and a controlled emergency landing. By joining our channel, you become part of a proactive movement dedicated to enhancing energy resilience and sustainability from the ground up. Together, we can drive the energy transition of the normal folks like you and me, ensuring a more secure and efficient energy future for us all. Help first yourself so that you are able to help the people around you, just like they say in the airplane about the oxygen masks. Join us today and be the change we need. You can do that by thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and also visiting my Facebook groups in English and in Italian. Now let's see how an easy trick can help you save energy. So a few examples with the ceiling fan, but also with the heat pump. Tropical ceiling fans can help us in the winter with destratification and mix the air to even out the temperatures in the vertical direction. They are especially useful in high places, with the extreme example of a church. In my case, 30 years ago, I used a vertical ceiling fan to push the warm air down. If this fan is too expensive, and also the installation on the ceiling can be a challenge, you can start with a table fan or two mounted on a wall. Just make sure that it has a low speed in order to avoid annoying drafts. As in this video here, you can connect two table fans in series to give both of them half the voltage if the lowest speed is still too high. I see recommendations to push the air upwards in the winter. And indeed, some of these ceiling fans have also a winter switch. It may be too, but for me, it seems that pushing the warm air down, so in the same direction as you do in the summer, works well if nobody is for a long time under this fan. At least we were happy 30 years ago with this solution. Before installing a fan, measure temperatures at different heights. A simple thermometer can reveal the extent of stratification in your home. As an example, in staircases, heat naturally moves upwards. This can be an advantage if you want heat to accumulate in the evening on the upper floor. Or it is a problem. It depends on your home layout. But the key is to keep it under control. For example, separating with a door or curtain the heated rooms from the staircase. A. Energy efficiency and money. It avoids higher heat loss up there at the ceiling where the air will be really warm. Insulation up there must really be very good to keep the energy inside. And think a moment of how much energy you save for each degree Celsius that you reduce and that your heating system must deliver. Thanks to this trick of bringing the warm air down, each degree Celsius reduces your energy bill by about 8%. So reducing the extreme temperature at the ceiling of, for example, 3 degrees Celsius can save you 20% by keeping the warm air where it belongs, on the floor. That is 100 or 200 euros per year. And that depends also in how many parts you do this in the house. If your total bill is about 1,000 euros per year, for this money, you pay back a decent ceiling fan in 1 year. And then in the summer, a nice cool breeze during the hot days is just a giveaway. B, you have also comfort improvement. So you have no more cold feet and hot bills.
No!
And it is ideal for rooms which are higher than normal, for example, more than 3 meters. And C, you don't need big machines. Fans consume only about from 15 to 60 volts, which is far less than letting run the heating system harder. Well, let's say that they cost only 1 cent per hour, but that will save you that money mentioned before, and it keeps your legs warmer. Now, back to my earlier point about heat pumps. They don't just move air, they transfer heat, even uphill on the temperature scale, using refrigerant cycles. An idea that I really would like to implement is to use it for fresh air exchange. See video 3, it's a long time ago, where I proposed it, but I never realized it. It's a small heat pump recycled from an old humidifier that recovers the heat from old air that is driven outside to transfer its heat to the air, pressure air which is coming inside. Nowadays, the air change is normally done, in the best case, with a simple passive heat exchanger. But that is not so efficient, because the temperature difference between the outgoing air and the incoming air is not so huge. And yet, it's an important thing to do for your health. The recommended air changes per hour, or ACH, is about 1/3. So every 3 hours, you should completely change all the air in the rooms where you live continuously. With a heat pump, you can raise the air temperature, which is coming inside, up to 30 degrees Celsius or so, while the old air is going outside really cold, and who cares? With such an efficiency, you can also make smaller holes in the wall. Another example, the mobile air conditioner has a cold air exit and also a warm air exit. They are separated. We have a basement that starts with a staircase from the kitchen. You can aim the cold jet into the staircase and it will fall into the basement, while the warm jet goes into the house. Also, the warm air in the basement will be pushed into the kitchen, because it must compensate for the air that is added to the basement. Well, that is a good use of the heat pump, and it is also a way to let air stratification help us. Maybe this last example is not a good solution for the long run, because your basement might become really cold. But to quickly raise the temperature when you come in a cold house, it can be helpful. To sum up, vertical fans, ceiling fans, are not just for summer cooling. Use them in the winter mode to blow warm air up and then along the walls down without creating annoying drafts. Or use summer mode to quickly mix the warm with the cold air in spaces where no one is direct in the airflow. And regarding heat pumps, I gave you two examples that are both uncommon applications of known technology. I hope you like it. If you have tried these examples, or if you have questions, just write in the comments below. And don't forget to like and to subscribe to the channel for more do-it-yourself saving tips in your home. I wish you good energy.